Hey there guys, OGM here, welcome back to Minecraft Story Mode. So guys, last time, we were lied to, there's no way around it. We went in, saved a civilization, and then got shot in the back. No way around it. That was it. That basically sums up the last episode. The last episode could have been completely avoided if we didn't get shot in the butt. But you know, it's fine. With that being said though, everyone, welcome to episode 8. A Journey's End.
These builders truly existed, and if you found their temple, that means we're one step closer. That's not what I was expecting.
See, this is what I'm talking about. We're stuck in a rut, go through a portal, avoid dying long enough to get back to this stupid hallway.
Wash, rinse, repeat? Yes. It would be nice if whoever made these left some sort of signs, guideposts.
You can call me Harper.
Your bravery is an impressive quality. I look forward to studying that aspect of your personality once you have been made useful.
We'll see about that.
No!
What is that?
This is the redstone heart.
Beautiful.
It can help you find your way home.
How is this gonna do that?
The answers you're seeking, the old builder's atlas, your way home, they're all right up those stairs.
Adventure?
All right. That was actually a pretty good wrap-up. I think that was probably the best wrap-up we've had in this whole entire, I guess, new Order of the Stone series.
That's a lot of stairs.
And Lucas still has his book. Okay, cool. So we have our book explaining every door so far. We're going to go get an atlas, so Lucas's book is kind of pointless at this point. But I guess it does kind of take a first-hand experience, and that is kind of unique in and of itself. But, you know, whatever. Anyway, here we go. Got the redstone heart back. The gate's still open, so that works. But, okay, let's go home. Let's do it.
Time to go home.
Yes, please.
I can't believe we're finally this close.
Yeah, to be fair, we are really close, actually. Like, we're here. We can taste it.
Very odd to be back.
Oh, you just love being mysterious, don't you? Is that, like, your favorite thing?
What?
Probably.
I just
especially when she has nothing better to do.
Kind of thought I'd never need to come back, to tell you the truth.
Where are we? This looks like the end. Like, with all the stars and everything, but it's not as purple and deadly. It's like an actual nighttime sky.
What are you hiding from us now, Harper?
Nothing!
This is actually really cool. I like these stars. It looks just like the end, but less ominous and less dragon-filled. No death. All adventure, in other words.
Still don't like it when you call us that.
I'm telling you, call them originals. Yeah, that should have been an option for me to call them. If they were before the Order of the Stone, which became a legend in and of itself, which was our heroes, I'm telling you, call them originals. They were the first. If you don't like the term old builders.
Are you joking? You think you're nice?
Yeah, I don't know if you remember the whole Pama thing, but
hey, I had good intentions with that, all right? Don't make me regret helping you.
Well, you're going to give us the Atlas.
To be fair, all the sass that you're giving us, I would gladly push you over the edge, and you kind of almost killed us already. So I really don't blame the crew wanting to kill you off or get rid of you as soon as possible. Of course. Of course. So you just lied to us again, and we're only 4 minutes into the episode. Are you serious?
I'm sure we can figure something out. Make a deal.
Are you serious? They're not going to give it up. You said we had to go up the stairs and get the atlas. You didn't say anything about there had to be like, oh, you go up the stairs and you have to make a deal of your lifetime, sell your soul, and then you get the atlas. No, you said we're going to go and get the atlas and get home. Are you serious?
Great, remember?
Come on.
No, I think she's definitely hiding something. But if we're going,
oh my gosh. I do not like this chick at all already. This chick is insane.
Get home.
I'm sorry to hear you feel that way, Jesse. Sorry.
Wait, what?
Resist a good eavesdrop. I promise.
I like how the thing's like, and Harper too? Question mark? I like how they actually said that. That was kind of smart.
A door? Like a regular door?
Okay.
Find out.
Yeah, she's still hiding something. I don't care what you say. Open the door. And what is it? It's got particles, so it instantly makes me think that we're not done here. It's a portal. We all just disappeared. It was a portal, and it had particle effects, like I said. So we're going to another dimension. So this must be, like, the ultimate. This must be the king dimension. Since this one had not only an ominous stairwell, but also needs the redstone heart. Where the heck are we? Wait, is this Spleef? Is this Spleef? This is actual Spleef.
Seems as if some new competitors have entered the match.
My, isn't that...
Is this a game? Where's Harper? Keep moving. Yeah, keep moving. Honestly, my advice in any type of Spleef, unless it snowballs, is keep moving. If it snowballs, that's another story, but this is just... Why do they have people throwing TNT? I didn't even notice that until just now. Why are we throwing TNT? This is a bad idea. Yeah, that's true. That is actual Spleef. Okay, dodge. Who's Tim? Be like Tim! Who's Tim? Is Tim, like, supposed to be his captain or something? I'm like you, Tim! I got you! Is it something like that? And also, green big woman is not happy that we killed little green man or woman or what, really whatever it was, I don't know. I kind of really wasn't paying attention. I just kind of killed them, admittedly. Dodge, dodge. They won't let me dodge. Why would that not let me dodge? That, like, made me wait until the last second. I kept spamming the move. It would not let me move. Okay, so we're already down 3 hearts. This is not good. And everyone's... Help Ivor, help Petra. Okay, well... Oh, shoot. Okay, we're going for Petra. We went through already. We'll go for it again. Go. Go. Okay, cool. They're safe. And then did Lucas save Ivor? Good. No? Oh, shoot.
No.
It can't be. Whoa, no way, dude. I got a double.
Wait. Are they dead then? Like, permanently dead?
Hey, whoa.
That was their equipment. What? Okay, hold on a second. Spleef is Spleef is meant to be a game. Okay, first off. Second off, we just watched our friends explode. That was their inventory on the ground. They're dead. There's no way. They're gone. How are there rules about killing one another? And in Spleef, there's never been rules. It's been get rid of anyone. And also, yeah, kind of the most logical one. You're not my buddy. You killed my friend. Yeah, you killed my friends. Exactly. Exactly. What?
Whoa. Hang on, dude. I am not in charge here, okay? It's them.
Who is them?
Yes. We are the ones in charge here.
Them.
Never had to stop a match. Ever.
Hello, them. Who are you?
What is going on here?
Maliva?
Immediately.
Wow, for being obsidian, he moves pretty fast. How does he move that fast with obsidian? I'm rather impressed, actually. I'm not even mad right now. That's impressive. What enchantment does he have on his stuff? Or what potion is he drinking every 5 seconds? Yeah, someone start explaining right now. What's going on here? You've killed my friends. We fell in the middle of a Spleef arena. Harper is... No one even knows right now. I can't even give an explanation for that. What's going on right now?
And technically against the rules.
We weren't even part of the game, if you want to even call this a game right now. Like, that wasn't even a fair Spleef. You were throwing in TNT. You were killing people, which never happened. Well, I guess it kind of does happen in Spleef, but you know what I mean. Like, they don't just die. You normally respawn at the top, like, hey, ha, I died. We're all good to go again. It's not just like you explode and lose all your inventory. That's never happened in any game of Spleef that I've played before. And you guys know, with the battle mode, we have Spleef now. We've done it on Xbox. We've done it even before the update with Spleef. Or Tumble, whatever you want to call it. We've done it. How is it the fact that you're actually calling this a game when you're killing each other off? Wait, what?
Obviously. They come back, and then we have them go work in the mines.
Jesse!
What? Okay, so Ivor's there. Lucas, also Lucas is back in his ocelot gear. Okay.
It's just a game.
Let my friends go.
If this is a game, that's a very violent game. Are you just trying to get everyone's gear and then like sell it or use it for yourself? What are you doing? That's very odd for how you're taking everyone's gear.
We're not monsters.
In our games, when people die, they reappear in one of our respawn zones.
Okay.
I hear it's still pretty painful, though.
Well, sport, now that you've come and interrupted our games, I'm sure our fans would love to know how you got here. Spill.
Go, why bother?
Okay. We're from another world, none of your business. A stairway. Actually, this guy's been all over our business so far. I really don't think he deserves any explanations just yet. His name's Hadrian? And also, okay, as good as you'll look in the mines, he's already threatening us, and we've not even been in the, we're not even a part of his games. Okay, lovely. Lovely.
I must say, this return is unexpected.
You're telling me. I'm here for Jesse.
Oh.
Okay.
Really? So tell me, Jeff, why do you think Harper brought you here?
My bet's on Pet.
We're trying to get home. She's supposed to help. We need to actually, yeah, kind of slap her in the face, but at the same time, it is truthful, and it's just barely enough. Yeah, exactly. He said exactly the way I would. She was supposed to help us get home, but she kind of then stabbed us in the back. Again, 4 minutes into the episode. Are you serious?
Well, that's all
also,
well
his
good.
Atlas. Why would we so if it's his Atlas, that means that he is an old builder. So, Hadrian, Harper, and I'm going to assume these two as well.
Yeah, ask Harper. She's the one helping.
Right. Yes. Believe me, Hadrian. When you see what Jesse
okay, so Hadrian,
has,
Harper, Believa, or... Belevin? I don't remember the chick's name already. Whatever the chick is and the black guy. That's the crew right now. We got an old dude, Harper, and a chick who's a brown noser and the other thing. And also, what's not going to send us to a mine? I would assume the thing that got us here, the redstone heart. That's what I would assume.
The redstone heart? Huh. Seems like only yesterday someone took off with that and vowed never to return with it.
Oh, so maybe that's why. Harper isn't exactly... Harper's corrupt then.
Pretty dangerous if you don't know how to use it.
Hadrian, you're not...
Okay, hold on a second. So, Harper took this and ran. Harper wants revenge, and so he's willing to work with us.
You give me the heart.
Or excuse me, not Harper. Hadrian, I just realized what I said. Hadrian.
I never look at your insignificant face again.
Oh, okay,
wait,
lovely.
Atlas? But how will we get home?
So, not my problem. This is a one-time offer. You've caught me in a forgiving mood.
I don't play that way, Hadrian. If I can't have the Atlas, you can't have the Redstone Heart.
Fact.
Come on, gang, let's get out of here.
Oh, wait.
Oh, here we go. Here we go. It
suits everyone.
Well, okay.
Joe, I admit, you do drive a hard bargain. I'm sure I could think of something fair for the both of us. Well,
I don't know why it would be fair. We just gave you an offer and you turned it down. You give us the Atlas, we give you the heart. That's the fairest we can give it. We get what we want and you get your trophy back from Harper, I guess.
If you win... The Atlas is yours to keep.
Okay.
It's a good deal,
and if you win...
Trust me. Everyone enjoys these games.
Yeah, again, you didn't say what happens if you win, so I'm not going to trust that.
Once a rule is written into the bylaws, we make sure it's enforced.
Oh.
Is that right, Hadrian?
Oh, yeah. Otto is a real stickler for the rules.
Okay, so
all right, then.
Otto's the voice of reason, but he really is the law. So if you break the law, no matter what it is, he's going to stick by whatever the law actually says. So basically,
have to go to the mines too.
Oh, there we go. Okay. So if we lose, we lose everything. We still lose our inventory, and Harper now has to go to the mines as well, even though she's not part of the game. And if we win, we get the Atlas. That still seems very steep against us. I feel like, though, just by the way that they're giving us this information already, that somehow we're going to have to get, I guess, like an underground type of organization going here where we're going to have to slightly bend the rules to our favor. And yeah, first off, you get nothing for my respect. You lied to us. That's, yeah, definitely. Definitely you lied to us. That is the best way to go about it.
I didn't lie per se.
I didn't tell the whole truth. No, there's nothing about it. You lied. You said that we were going to come here, get the Atlas, and get home. I was expecting an adventure in our own world to finish this off. But no, that's it. You lied, got us trapped in here now, and now we're fighting for the dude's amusement, and we're also fighting for your life. Not only did you screw yourself, you screwed us by getting us involved in this game. This is your fault. Not once, but twice now. Because of Palma, and now this.
We used to have competitors from all over travel here to play in the games. At least until the others ruined it.
What happened?
Who are the others? Unless you mean like Hadrian. Okay, yeah.
They started pitting people against each other. Just for sport.
Okay.
Forcing people to be here. It isn't right.
I'll agree with that. I do like the whole entire ice sword, though. That's actually kind of nice. Ice swords? That's really cool, actually. Oh, there's a little polar. Look at the little polar bear babies. They're so adorable.
Sort of a home away from home for all the people playing the game.
Wow. I can't believe that was the intro sequence. I kind of like how they had the Minecraft story mode above that, though. That was actually kind of cool.
Are all of these people competitors?
Yeah.
Smart how they did all the words, too.
Stuck working in the quartz mines. Those poor souls are just waiting for their next shot. Mining
quartz mines.
I feel bad for the people that are too scared or weak to play in the games.
Wow, that's just horrible.
Wow. Wow. Look at all those people. You can see that they've been abused. That's insane. They've been beaten down. Also bred. Oh. And then the big old fat guys don't even let anyone eat. So not only are there... Okay, I feel like this is a combination between episode 5 and then episode 7. 7 because everyone's working against the will, aka the slavery right here with the whole entire mines. Episode 5 because they're now being starved, so not only are they fighting for their own freedom, but now they're also fighting for their own survival with the food aspect. The only thing we're missing is episode 6, which would be the whole entire fact that we need someone to just... I guess, want to try and...
Trying to make sure we all know who's boss.
I don't even know at this point. Like, they just... They need someone to try and go crazy and just murder everyone. But I guess that would kind of fall on Hadrian, but he's not really murdering. He's making everyone else murder for him. So I don't really know how to go about that. But this kind of seems like a hybrid episode so far. I kind of like it, but at the same time, it's kind of insane, admittedly.
Gotta get our friends out of the mines quick.
I'll go ask some of the other competitors.
Okay, so let's see here. What's going on here? We've got... Face meat, okay. That's the portal to the mines, the quartz mines. And then I saw people here that we can probably talk to. Wait, what's this say? Hold on a second. Here lies a platform on which Tim stood to win the great games.
Here lies the platform on which
Oh, of course, now he's going to read it. Of course. Okay, well, that works too.
Hope I'll be standing there soon.
Is that Tim? Is that meant to be Tim? Okay. So, Tim's worshipped because he won the games.
Wow.
So, he's the first, and I'm going to assume only victor then? Maybe that's why Hadrian and Minerva went crazy because they lost and they get mad with power? Is that what I'm supposed to understand here? And we're supposed to feel sorry for that somehow? Even though they're starving these people? Maybe?
Hey! Get out of here before I see if I can attach this sign to your head.
Oh.
It's so nice.
How kind.
Contestants are in the village. It's lovely.
Have you seen my friends? I'm fine out here. Why is everyone so cranky? Yeah, have you seen my friends first off?
You know the ones that got eliminated in Spleef?
No, but if I do, I will make them wish for elimination again.
Oh. Lovely. Okay, what do you do here besides try to make everyone starve?
You know, being a great gladiator, I hand out the daily food rations and guard the food, so no one tries to sneak any.
Okay, they give daily food rations, then why are you...
Could be that we're forced into an endless cycle of destruction. Just a guess, though.
Fine, I'm out of here.
I see. Okay.
Can't wait to kill you again.
Okay, so even though that she's deliberately starving people, I guess she's not really starving. Maybe there's an allowed time for lunch or something. I mean, okay, I fully understand. She did chase away that girl, and I do understand that. But that seems very odd. Okay, so purple doesn't like us. Blue doesn't like us. Okay, what's this? Banner. A banner of Tim.
Not as sweet as mine, of course.
That was it. All right. And Slab. Okay. Hello, Slab. Who are you?
You say something, Tiny, because I'm trying to read here.
Where'd you get that book?
Oh, this? Fished out some respawn's inventory after he... It's got some tales of adventure, feelings, and other dumb stuff. Hey, wait a minute.
You're the freak
that knocked me out of my tower.
Yes.
And this belonged to that little blonde buddy of yours.
Yes.
You want this back?
That would be nice.
There are some fascinating and thrilling tales in here, and I like to read.
Can we make a deal? It seems like you people like deals. Can we make a deal? Okay, that doesn't answer my question, though.
If you do everything I say, when I say it, and don't make me mad again, maybe I'll consider giving you this stupid book back.
Ooh. Okay. So if we do everything that he says, he'll give us the book back. And Lucas does need that book, because that's what's going to make us get home.
Wow. Hey, you are the crazy.
Okay, that's actually kind of a sucky deal, but at the same time, it is a deal.
More than I can say for most, but not even a third.
People love Tim, huh? Did you meet Tim? Way better than Tim. Okay, hold on. Did you meet Tim?
Me? Meet Tim? Oh, I wish. Here's the secret.
Okay.
We're all just trying to be like Tim.
Well, I kind of got that. The one dude that ran at me was like, "For Tim!" I don't know who Tim is, but apparently he really liked him. And you guys all worship Tim, basically. You have a living embodiment of Tim in the central courtyard. I mean, how else am I supposed to go about that? Also, Hippie Chick, you killed Lucas and Ivor.
Whoa.
What the heck?
You from Spleef. You were, like, amazing. I'm Nell.
And hello, Nell.
So, super sorry about your friend. I get your problems upset.
Rob's upset.
I had no idea what was going on. it wasn't very chill.
No, yeah, it wasn't. And yes, I am mad you
totally
killed them. Granted, I understand they're safe now, and I respect that, but still, what the heck's going on here?
I do not want to be on your bad side.
Okay.
I gotta say, you keep playing like that, and you'll be like Tim status.
Again, Tim.
Like you could.
Oh, I was right. So Tim did win then. They all worship him because he won.
Compare you to Tim. It might be a little...
I see.
Or not. It's cool.
I'm not here to be...
So everyone's trying to get home, and Tim's the only one to ever get home. That's why they all want to get home.
Tim either.
I get it.
Whole team home. Listen, I still feel super bad about taking out your friend. I owe you.
Okay.
So if you ever need anything, you just come and ask. Cha?
Cha? Cha. Okay, cha. I feel like I'm talking to a surfer dude. Good to know. If you ever need help, come talk to me.
Hey.
Cha. Just, okay, that's it.
You're
we're done.
You're the one that eliminated the one decent member of my team.
And you're...
I'll barely be able to...
Wait, is that the guy that I killed or is that a girl? I don't know.
I know I'm good at
and
things, but I'm not
your team
bad.
Killed Lucas. We're even.
And
yeah,
we're even.
I'd call it that.
Oh,
we're
no
even.
No way we're even. You still have a good teammate left. And you still have all your fancy gear. I'm stuck with
you. You don't think that that makes...
Next
oh.
Round.
Glad that you don't have any faith in your friends.
You
also,
will.
Hold on a second. Why are you big? But no one else is big. Why are you big?
But the gladiators are trained for...
I mean, I guess Axel's big.
And they are
but Hold on a sec. That makes no sense. Everyone else here is tiny. Why are you so big?
The best person will win.
And that's going to be me.
Seriously? You know you're looking at the best person. I feel
or not.
Bad for you. Most of us got snatched against our wills, but you got tricked into coming willingly. That old builder should have told you these games were impossible.
I'm not going to lie. I was hoping that that would have come off more snarky, to be fair. But apparently not. Anyway, here we go. Tim won the games. That is true.
Tim won.
So if Tim won, then we can clearly get out as well.
Tim. Yeah, well, good luck with getting home.
Do you not believe in Tim? I mean, for real though. Yeah, Tim. That's very ominous. And also wood planks. Are we supposed to gather them or something? Okay, no, it's just... Great, we have wood planks. Maybe we can train on them or something. Good to know. Okay, anyway, we've not talked to you yet. Hello, Face Meat.
Hello?
What a name, Face Meat.
Don't you hello, Face Meat. Wait a minute. You're the cheater that blew up my friend, Slab. And Face Meat doesn't rock cheaters.
Again, I still don't see how that's cheating, but okay. What do you do around here? Tell me about the old... Yeah, what do you do around here, first off, Face Meat? Since apparently everyone's got their own job except for Slab. Slab's kind of reading. Tell me about the old builders. What do you know about them, if anything, at this point? I really don't feel like you would know anything. I feel like you're one of those just big old muscle meatheads, to be fair. Not big on hugs. Yep, he's definitely a meathead. There you go. Where are my friends?
In the mines. Duh. And they're not going anywhere. Not on Face Meat's watch. That doesn't mean
okay.
Stand there.
Let them go, please. Get my friends now. Let me help
your
you in some
face.
Way.
Please, what can
okay,
I do
hold on
now?
A second. Am I able to work out a deal with Face Meat as well?
Face Meat was busy slamming mad reps at the gym and missed lunchtime. You see? So Face Meat's
okay.
Hungry. Do something about that, and Face Meat will think about getting your friends out.
All right, well then. The big old lady, she has food, and so if we get our daily ration, we can go ahead and just forfeit it to Face Meat, I guess. That would work, right? Yeah, I mean, we can talk to her again. So,
oh,
hey, what's
you
up?
Again. The one I wanted to make suffer. Hey, leave before I ruin you.
We just want our daily ration, that's it. Yeah, can I have some bread? Perfect.
Have some of that bread? It's for that guy over there.
Seriously? I'm not falling for that. No bread until lunchtime. Get out of here before I make you into a meal.
Okay.
Does
well.
Any food I can borrow or will have? I guess I should ask around.
And it's looking at her. Okay, well then that obviously answers the question where we're supposed to go. We're supposed to go to her. But also at the same time... That answered my question, too. They're not exactly tyrants here. Sure, they're being very, very ruthless with the whole entire food thing. But, interesting. That's very interesting.
Well, if I had some wheat, I would totally give you some. Sadly, I don't have a secret stash. And if
oh, she doesn't have a secret stash. And if you didn't ask, I wouldn't loan you some. Yeah, yeah, yes. Oh, I like how not only did she do it, she's like, wink. Oh, that was great. That was beautiful. Thank you. Thank you, game. I'm so glad that you actually went the whole entire extra 10 yards just to add in that wink. That was great. I approve. 10 out of 10 on that one. Good job, game. Proud of you. That was actually... Very well written, just for that.
Go ahead. That should be enough for your bread.
All of it?
How did no one notice this?
Sprout. It'll grow back. Just, leave the seeds, yeah?
Cha? Cha?
One.
Just regrow the seeds, cha?
Go.
I feel like that's me, though, all the time on stream. Please replant the seeds. Please replant the seeds. Please replant the seeds. And yet no one ever does. How often do you guys see me replanting the seeds on our own stream? Because you guys won't replant my seeds.
Looks like that should be enough for some
Please replant my seeds. Please.
Yeah, that means bread.
Hopefully bread will be enough to get that Face Meat guy to help me.
Righteous.
Okay, well now we still need a crafting table. Oh, there you go. There's problem number two.
A few wood planks
but, that's what I was going to say. I did see
right
that.
On.
Thank you, Nell.
Hey, no problem. Happy to help. Catch you later, yeah?
Catch you later, yeah? Like, cha. What a voice. Like, that's... That voice, man. I don't even know how to wrap my head around that. I really feel like I'm just listening to, like, a classic surfer movie. Or, like, even, like, think of, like, Rocket Power. With, like, with Raymundo. How he's always like, yeah, guys, yeah. It makes me laugh, actually. That's a perfect voice for it. Okay, so we got the crafting table. And now we're making bread.
Let's make some food.
Cool. All right, so 3 wheat equals bread. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, bread. Nice.
Boom, bread. Now I should be able to get my friends back.
Cool. Let's go. To face meat. Face meat. I have food for you. Eat it.
Hello?
Hey, I have some bread for you.
Got some bread for you.
Bread, huh? It's not cake, but face meat is starving. It's so...
Fair enough. Hey, bread ain't free. Get my friends... Yeah, bread ain't free, definitely.
You better hold up your end of the deal.
Jeez, face meat didn't know you were so demanding. Wait here.
I was gonna say, you can at least eat your bread while you're getting it. That's fine.
Hey, glad to see you already figured out the whole nether portal.
I don't even know where she went, to be fair. She, like, kind of just disappeared in a house or something.
Nice, nice. It seems like we keep ending up in situations. First with Palma, now with that stupid sploof game.
Sploof game?
What I'm trying to say is...
I like it, sploof.
You know, don't...
Who doesn't love a good game of sploof? I love sploofing about.
I thought I should say something.
Petra, I thought you were gonna die.
Me too. I'm glad Lucas and Ivor respawned. I can't...
Hey man. The Jesse and Petra romance continues to grow. It's beautiful. I still see these two hooking up. I mean, after all, they hooked up basically the first four, so continue the relationship. I'm calling it now.
Jesse. Man, is it good to see you.
You too, Lucas.
And I'm not gonna lie, I kinda like Lucas without his armor. I prefer him in the Ocelot gear. What the heck is Ivor wearing? He's in boxers and a wife beater. That's
anyway.
My outfit breathes wonderfully. Okay. I'm wow. Wow. Okay.
I'm working on that. It's tricky though.
Well, don't beat around the bush. What has Harper gotten us wrapped up in?
Yeah. Harper is a...
Okay, it's just the games were in trouble as long as I have you guys.
Jesse?
Kinda are in trouble, to be fair.
Careful. If Petra and I don't win the next round, we're gonna all be sent back through that nether portal.
That is true.
No way.
Hey!
But also, at the same time, to be completely... Hello? Who are you? Okay.
In there, Jesse.
Anyway, what I was going to say... To be fair, I made a deal. Going to get the, yeah, I made a deal. That's what I was going to say. I made a couple deals. I made a deal with the big guy, Slab, in order to get your journal back. And we... Yeah, okay, look. So it's even referencing Slab. So we have to keep up this deal. If not for the diary, but for something else. Definitely. Got to keep that in mind. Okay.
Entire team across the finish line.
Yeah, it's super fishy.
Well, you're out of those mines now. According to Harper,
and to be fair, that big girl, M, does not exactly like Tim.
Right.
She's like, yeah, Tim. So what, was like Tim a coward or something and like ran? And because he ran, was there a legend of him or something?
Otto, my old friend. Like I said, he may be able to help.
Okay, let's see here.
So you're the one who's supposed to help us?
Well, I'll enforce the rules at any rate. If that helps you, then... can't be games without rules.
So like I said, we have to bend the rules into our favor in order to win. That's what it seems like. Because obviously, Hadrian and Minerva are corrupted. They are completely power hungry right now. So they're going to just annex the rules any chance that they get. So if we're just like, hey, that's against the rules, someone stop them, they'll have to stop. And that's the way that we're going to win this. I guarantee it.
I can feel change in the air.
Great, as long as
I guarantee that's how we're going to win this.
That is the point, but you have to win first. And my job is to make sure everybody, even Hadrian, plays
by the
rules.
Yeah, even Hadrian plays by the rules. He just said it himself. That's it. We have to find something where Hadrian is deliberately breaking the rules, and we have to call him out on it. Even if it's in the middle of a game, just call him out on it. Be like, you broke the rules, you're out, let me finish this game fairly. And if we beat it fairly, then it's it. So I don't know if it's going to be like something like Banjo-Kazooie, where there's like almost not necessarily a quiz show at the end of the game, but it's like we're running through the actual final gauntlet, and then it's like, look to your left, there's Hadrian, look to your right, there's, I guess, Petra running and you need to protect her. What do you do, call him out, or do you save Petra? And I hate to say it, but even though that we're going to kind of betray Petra, I'd rather call out Hadrian, because then we can at least get him in his own lie. Whereas, unfortunately, we lose Petra, and I don't like that idea. We know that she's not going to necessarily die. She's just going to be put into the mines with Lucas and Ivor, who are still alive. So, I guess keep them safe in the mines, as safe as that can be, rather. And if it comes under the option, I'm calling out Hadrian now. It's not worth it.
We are still making a strong showing, but after yesterday's performance in Spleef,
the Spleef Arena. Who doesn't love a good Spleef?
Oh,
red team's gone.
Oh.
And of course about
okay. And wait, are we supposed to be the red team now then? Is that what I'm understanding here? We're the red team?
Don't forget to be like
okay.
Wonder how this is.
What a pompous jerk. They love Tim. Yeah, I definitely agree with that one actually. Pompous, for sure. But like I said, if it comes down to it, if it's going to be we have to pick between Hadrian or Petra, sorry guys. Hadrian's what I'm picking. We have to take him down as soon as possible.
Starting line, huh?
A race! We've totally got this!
Got this, huh?
How did he get down here so fast? Unless that was a pre-rendering.
How we doing, everybody?
It's Hadrian!
That had to be a pre-rendered voiceover. Because he got down here way too fast. I don't care what anyone says.
Explosive debut in Spleef. Tell me, champ. What's on your mind as you approach the next challenge?
How I'm going to defeat you.
We have appearance.
Yeah, actually, a fair contest. That's going to slap in the face, actually, considering the fact that I feel like he's cheating with that whole entire TNT with Spleef.
Nobility, huh? Don't you worry. That's what these games are all about. Just ask Tim.
And everyone's afraid of him. Okay.
But I must ask, what makes you think you can win when so many others have failed?
The fact that I'm still saying you're not playing fair. Yeah, your pride. Here we go. Your pride is your weakness, actually. And I still call it. If it comes down to a choice, I'm taking out Hadrian. Screw Petra. I'm taking down Hadrian. Because Otto wants to uphold the rules. He doesn't care what it takes. Even Hadrian. That seems such an oddly specific detail. Even Hadrian has to be watched.
I'm sure you'll be great, but, well, everyone could always use a little dose of luck, right?
Yeah, it does seem kind of odd, too. Especially as sticky as she was yesterday. Now she's just like, I'm happy now.
Brr. About my old teammate you eliminated. Well, I was thinking about how you handled Spleef.
And Hippie Girl didn't seem too trustworthy either on that one, did she?
I thought, an enemy of my enemy is my friend.
Em might be up to something.
So, yeah, I'm feeling it, Petra.
How about we work together on this?
How about no? How about no? Nah, I'm not feeling it.
Come on, Jesse. I'm trying to help.
Maybe I can trust you. Come on, you're up to something. Yeah, come on, you're up to something.
You mean to believe that? What are you up to here?
Nothing, honest. It's just watching you negotiate with Hadrian, trying to get home. It inspired me. Made me want to go home too. We should be working.
Made me want to go home too? So you mean that you've just been deliberately losing on purpose? Wait, hold on, hold on, hold on. There are a ton of grit. How do you know about the gladiators? What?
Well, what do you say? Unless you don't want the help of a former gladiator. I mean, that's okay too.
I'm gonna stick with my team, and you should stick with yours.
Unless you don't help. Okay, so M is a former gladiator that's now fallen. So if the gladiators fail too, they fall. Maybe that's why Slab is afraid of us right now. Because, sure, he has the diary, and we still need that. That is Lucas's. We need that. And it's got our adventures. We know that. But at the same time, if M used to be a gladiator, that means that the gladiators will fall at one point. And if they do, they become regular, I guess, volunteer, not really kind of forced into it racers. So that's why Slab's afraid of us. So we need to appease Slab still, yes, to get the diary, but also, if we appease Slab enough, will he actually tell us what's going on with M? Because there's something that she's not telling us. Obviously, if she knows about the gladiator ring in the center, does she still have connections to the other big guys?
It is a total bummer that we are not going to be able to, you know, work together.
Sorry you're going to lose now.
I still think you're awesome, though.
Competitors,
okay. Good to know. So Hippie's still on our side. The black guy is, I guess, just there. M is currently confident and cocky as all get out because she used to be a gladiator. Petra's with us, and then the other two teams we don't even know because they won't talk to us. Lava Curtain. All right, we've dealt with this before. Lava Curtains are things that we've dealt with before. No big deal. Go between this. Still no big deal. This is not difficult whatsoever. Kind of just running through point A to point B right now. If this is a race, I see no difficulty in this. That was actually, okay, I take it back. That would be kind of difficult. I mean, I understand this is still just button mashing right now. I obviously know what I'm doing. But this isn't that bad, actually. Not yet, at least. And this is obviously kind of parkour. This isn't that hard.
We did it.
I apparently didn't hit that at the right time, but I still like got it close enough to the end. Oh, man, what are we doing? This is going to be... Yeah, I guess this is going to kind of be easy. Wait, what? Oh, so we can attack. I didn't know we could actually attack each other. Especially after yesterday, they threw a kind of a big old fuss about it. But here we go. So now they have swords. We have swords. We're going to attack. Oh, there we go. There's one. Nope, not yet. Okay, I was going to hope that we could, like, knock them into each other and make them fall. Not necessarily just knock them out, but just make them fall into each other. There we go. Oh, okay, we killed them. Lovely. Not what I expected. Oh, jeez. Okay, I just got burnt. Not what I was hoping for. But I got burnt. I guess I didn't tap it fast enough or something. Okay, so there's five members, three left. Or maybe I just looked at it weird or something. But either way, there we go. We're still good. Water, we're still good. We're going. We're fine. Keep going, guys. We are going. We are going. We are swimming. And there's TNT. The only thing we've seen with TNT so far are the gladiators. So I'm going to assume this is the gladiator circle. Yeah, this is it. Cool. Oh. Okay, there's a black guy. Is he dead? No, he's in the water. He's fine. All right, cool. Ah, the other guys. The other big guys. All right, dodge that first off. Thank you, Petra. And now that black guy's definitely dead. And we got blown up by TNT. So we hit the lava, even though I dodged it. We also happen to get the TNT blowing up on us. We learned for the first time when we joined the games that we lose three hearts. So we probably have about five hearts now, meaning that we have five hits left before we're dead. This isn't good. And also, okay, hold on a second. I understand that M used to be a gladiator, but they're just letting her by without any fight whatsoever. So yes, to answer my question, she is still in with the gladiators. That's how she knew about that information. So good thing that we didn't team up with her, one. But two, M has her own nefarious purposes that she's trying to achieve here. We just lost another three hearts. What is that now? We have two hearts left, probably. Okay. I wish I had food right now to restore my health. Really do. All right, so it looks like Petra's going to sacrifice her body, isn't she? That was it. Okay, that's it then. We just lost Petra. Crap. And I'm going to go avenge her. Like, I know I could go after Slab, and that's probably the more logical thing here, but no, I actually rather avenge Petra. Because obviously they're not dead. We know that. We know that from Lucas and Ivor, so she can still see this. So they can't be mad at us later and want to betray us. That much I can say. So avenging Petra. I lost my sword. That sword lasted me for three whole episodes, and the fourth one it breaks. That's not what I was hoping for. I have one heart now. I have one heart. crap. I'm still alive, and I thought I lost 2 hearts from the lava. I must have only lost 1. So I have a heart remaining right now. This is insane. And there's vines. Okay.
Dude, I am, like, so close. I could do this.
Sorry, Nell. I'm winning this thing.
All right. Good to know, hippie chick. And lava. All right. So we got to climb. And we already know that our climbing is as fast as I can mash buttons or I can move my stick. So we're pretty much fine here as long as I just keep going. Oh, she killed her teammate. And okay, that's obvious. She helped us. We have to scratch her back. She scratched our back. We scratched her back. There's no way around it. And also, if we kind of... Water? There we go. We're so good. And now that's obsidian, isn't it? So Tim Righteous. Oh my gosh. All right, but there we go. Anyway, what I was going to say is the simple fact that now we're safe. Cha, follow me, dude. Yeah. Oh my gosh. Anyway, though, with that being said, so we saved her, we returned the favor, we don't owe her anymore. But what I'm going to actually talk about now is the fact that M was willing to betray her teammate. We already knew that she was up to her own nefarious ways when she kind of got by the gladiators. But is she trying to become a gladiator again, or is she trying to do her own thing? That's what I don't understand here. Because it seems very odd that she would betray her own team. Even when she went on that whole entire power fit, like, you killed my best teammate, now we're all going to lose, and blah, 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 blah.
I know who it might be. I am the winner of the lava race, the gladiator formerly known as Emily.
What?
Trust you made good on our deal.
I did.
Oh.
Then why hasn't Jesse responded yet?
Interesting. I made it. What you wouldn't exactly expect. And Emily failed. You tried to kill me. Surprised to see me? So glad I didn't trust you. Yeah, surprised to see me. That's a slap in the face for
you. See me here, did you?
This just went from bad to worse.
So you sacrificed winning the race to save someone else. Good to know.
Sounds like Cars. With the whole entire Mr. the King and Lightning McQueen.
No, please.
Yep. So Emily failed. She's no longer a gladiator. Interesting. What I don't understand is, why didn't Otto say anything against that? Because obviously, Otto, he even shook his head, so he knows that was against the rules to make a deal with the actual players. What's wrong here?
Just went up in smoke. So feel free to judge all you want. Hard to hurt me any more than Hadrian did just now.
Yeah, you trusted that creep? Exactly.
Guy's like a creeper in a purple power suit.
Hey!
In a purple power suit. That's amazing. I like it.
I'm out of here. Okay, respawning is the worst.
You. Hadrian wants you.
Hadrian?
Why does he want to see
okay.
me?
Okay.
You made him real mad. Come on. I don't have all day. I'm warning
what are you mad at? I want information first. Okay, let's go. I don't want to just leave, but at the same time, we have to kind of go.
Well, that was unexpected.
He said to get the diary. We have to just go.
Hadrian doesn't allow dirty respawns in the palace.
Okay. Well, be safe, Jesse. I don't trust them.
I don't trust them either, but like I said, I'm kind of just doing it just so we're good to go.
Hey, I need to talk to you.
Keep up. Come on.
Come here. It'll be quick.
Jesse.
Oh, crap.
Do what I say or not.
Hey, Jesse. Yeah.
Going to talk to him.
Jesse,
have to wait for me.
I'm warning you.
I'm
fine.
I appreciate you being considerate. My job's on the line here, too, you know. I hope Hadrian's in a good mood.
Hadrian's tough boss. Do you like your job?
Like this one.
Hadrian seems like a tough boss.
I don't want to be a jerk to the miners. We're trying to save the miners here, especially because our own groups are it. But
gets old, but I get to take out my frustrations on the little people.
Okay. So he doesn't exactly like Hadrian either. It gets old. But the same, like I said, the only reason why I'm even doing this, because I kind of feel like a jerk for just defying that minor right there. Like, he asked for us to help him, and I was just like, nah. That was a very jerk move, but at the same time, I need that diary. Lucas needs that pack. It's got our adventures in it. And as much fuss as is being made about it, I feel like there's something in it that's very important.
Just do that a whole bunch.
This is incredible. Such amazing.
This is very interesting, actually, as much crap as they're giving about this whole entire journal.
I get to hang out here whenever I want. And thanks to you actually helping us keep on schedule, we have some extra time to enjoy the place.
Good to know. Okay, well, he's happy.
Don't touch anything.
Okay, so don't touch anything. Got it.
Slab said don't touch anything. He never said don't look at everything.
Smart man. Smart man right there. Oh, another bookcase. How much do you want to bet? How much do you want to bet? 3 out of 4 so far has been Soren. How much do you want to bet it's Soren? Bye, Soren. That's it. We're done. Soren knows something. I know I've already said that. I said that back in episode 3. Well, I guess 7, but you know what I mean. Soren knows something if his books are turning up everywhere. Sure, he isn't an old builder. He's part of the Order of the Stone. But what does he know that he's able to keep popping up everywhere? Especially the portal book? That's oddly specific. And not just like the fact of, oh, it's a portal book. No, it's a portal book within the kingpin of portals, so to speak. This is the portal behind the portal. So there's something wrong here.
Impressive.
And also, is it just me, or does this look like it's got a bit of an outline to it? Like, here, I'm tracing the outline right now with my reticle, but it looks like this is an outline of, like, some type of wall or something. I don't know. Anyway, this is the armor of Tim. Why would they have that still? That makes no sense that they would actually have Tim's armor, considering the fact that he was supposed to escape.
Hey, that's that Tim guy's armor.
Welcome, Jesse. Fantastic to have you here. Just fantastic. Thanks for accepting my invitation. Well, it seems appropriate that you'd gravitate toward Tim's armor. What with everyone calling you the new Tim down there? Yes, I've heard that they're calling you that, and I can definitely see why. People love an underdog story.
Give it to me.
Tell me why I'm here, definitely.
Why, so we could continue to discuss the terms of our deal?
More terms?
We already have a deal. Like, there's no need to change the deal. We have it. We win, we get out. You lose, you let us go. There's no way around it.
Everyone loves him.
Yes, we all know that. You have him.
After all, he's Tim.
Yeah,
he gives them
hope.
Even better than that, they really believe in him. Tim is an inspiration to them, even when he's not here. One could say he's an inspiration because he's not here.
Because he's not here? What?
It's so much easier for a legend to stay nice and shiny when it's a fond memory. Easier to control it.
Easier to control it? Wait, are you saying this is all fake then?
With you still in the picture, it could get messy. I've been starting to think it would be best if you made a quiet exit. You don't belong here.
Are we changing our deal? I don't get to the point. Yeah, get to the point.
Do you have a point when you start talking, or you just hope to find one along the way? Because I'm getting really tired of listening to you blab.
Whoa!
I'm right there with you, to be fair.
Haven't you heard that patience is a virtue? See, there's something.
Don't really care. Get to the point.
No one ever wins unless we want him to. Not even Tim.
So I was right. We all know Tim won. I'm better than Tim. Is Tim even real? I called it then. No way. Is this it?
I knew you were a smart one, Bucko. Of course he's not real. Tim.
So no one's ever won then.
He keeps them playing the game.
After he said it's better to keep them shiny and new, it's easier to control. That was it. That was where he fell. So now, if we get this information to Otto, that's it. That's game over. We've won.
Wait, my treehouse?
He's tipped his hat.
The Atlas can see where people are from, you know. So I had Mevia go check it out.
Oh, it's Mevia. I thought it was Minerva, by the way he kept saying it. It's Mevia.
I was
Okay, Mevia. Apparently I can just... I'm not hearing everything right. It's Mevia. My bad. You guys are probably yelling at me by now. I apologize. Wait, was it really a door?
Olivia!
It was a door, and it is Axel and Olivia.
Oh my gosh, I can't believe what?
Yeah, this really scary lady showed up and knocked us out. Now we're in these smelly boxes.
What's going on here?
And that guy's voice is the worst.
I'm trying to find you. I promise I'll get you free. I won't lie, it's bad. I promise I'll get you free. Probably is the best thing to do. Because it gives them hope, but at the same time, it's not a complete lie. We're going to get them out eventually.
Kind of am different.
Oh.
I'm just glad we're all back together.
Wait until I tell
you. Yeah, I'll agree with that.
I've missed you guys so much.
Wow. This is just... Wow. Such a tapestry of human trauma and emotion. And we haven't even gotten to the best part. I saved that.
The best part?
What?
Oh,
what?
Your best friend.
My best friend. Wait, what? Reuben? Reuben's dead. We watched him die.
Sup?
Wait, that's the chicken guy. Oh my gosh.
Your best friend.
Yeah, you're an idiot. There's no way around it. Reuben died. We watched it.
You know that?
What? I told you, bro.
What?
My name is Reuben, but the Reuben you're thinking of, he was like a little piggy.
Oh. I didn't... Oh, okay. Okay, so that guy's name is Reuben. I didn't realize it.
See, even if you win, and that's a mighty big if, they will be staying to work in the mines forever. Or until they get a shot at competing, which is still basically...
No!
Okay, so what's your deal?
If you lose the next match and go work in my mines, then I'll let your friends go. All of them. You'll just have to stay behind in their place.
Okay.
Terrible in those mines.
Are you that scared? Actually, yeah. That's very true. If he's making a deal for all the friends to go, but not me, are you really that scared? You want me to throw it?
Pipsqueak interfering with my games. Okay, I had hoped that watching your sad reunion would be entertaining, but I'm done now. What do you say, sports?
I'm done now. It's done. We're done. Okay, goodbye.
Worth more than all of them.
To be fair,
really think you could win these games?
He's deliberately making us throw the game, so it's not... No.
Kind of a good
no,
deal.
If we're deliberately throwing the games, then we're going to be locked up and it's game over for us. We already know if we die, it's game over. So obviously, there's only one logical choice. Like, that just seems like just something stupid.
Get this garbage out of my office.
Sure thing, boss. Come on, idiot.
Why are you calling me an idiot? Dude, I've been nothing but kind to you so far. I swear, if you betray me, man... I'm not going to be happy if he betrays me. I made a deal with that guy to get that book back. He better not screw me at the very end. I've done nothing but been kind to him so far. Come on, man. Oh, I didn't realize either. That's the office right there overlooking the whole town. Wow. That's insane. That's not ominous whatsoever either. Looking up and just seeing them inside the office.
Was to snatch them from our world.
No.
Are they okay?
Other than Hadrian having them trapped in obsidian prisons. But he offered me a deal. He said he'll send you all home. If I lose and go to the mines in your place.
If I lose and go to the mines.
I didn't take the deal.
Oh, I guess that was probably the right move.
Probably.
Wow, they all sound so... Yeah, there's a no-win scenario. Exactly. It's a no-win scenario.
It's a no-win scenario, and I don't believe in those. I know
exactly.
You can find another way.
I just hope you know what you're doing.
Jesse was smart. Hadrian never would have kept that deal. Even if you did.
To be fair, he kind of betrayed her, of all people.
Send you all to the mines anyway.
Probably. While claiming that was the original deal.
So
yeah, to be fair, the deal, the quote-unquote original deal, the one that Otto heard, the one that he's going to upkeep, is the one that if we win, we win. If we lose, we all go to the mines. And that's the one that Otto heard. And obviously... Yeah, he's a stickler. Okay, exactly. He's a stickler for the rules. We need to still use that, like I said.
That's for sure. Always plays by him. If you won, I know he would definitely make sure you got that Atlas. That was the original deal.
Exactly. That was the original deal, like she just said.
We're going to end these.
Let's end this for good.
For good. Think you can handle that, Harper?
Oh, I think I've got some ideas.
Wait. you really think you can free everyone in this place and win the game?
Kind of a tall order, yeah. I will admit, but we do have more people than you do on your really team, to be fair. Everyone on your team has left you, except for the hippie, and the hippie's on our side anyway.
That is a pretty tall order, even for you, Jesse.
Oh, it's impossible.
We'll work together, exactly. Or actually, no.
Jesse?
I hit.
Whoa.
Okay, it's not going to work.
A little bit of an audience here.
I guess staying silent was kind of good because everyone came over. Even though I did hit one of the buttons, it didn't do anything. All right, let's do it. I guess I got to start making a speech here. These games are rigged. Stand up for the old builders. We all can win. These games are rigged, first off. We need to actually, like, slap them in the face with, like, facts first. Be like, look, this thing is fake. No matter what you do, you're not going to win. Exactly. Working together is the only way to do it.
I say it's our time to change the rules on them.
And like I said, catch them in a lie to actually do it. I've been saying that for a while. Don't you want to go home, Hadrian? Yeah, isn't fully in control. Hadrian fully isn't in control. It's split between the three of them.
Don't you want to win?
I do. More than anything. But nobody beats Hadrian at his own game. Nobody.
Hey, Tim did!
Oh.
That's the only thing keeping me going in.
Except
here.
Tim's not real. Oh, yeah. You're
but
right, he did.
If it were not for Tim, I probably would have given up a long time ago.
Actually, Tim's not real.
Okay, there's the stun factor.
Of course Tim's real. Look at the banners.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Okay, here we go.
I knew it.
So, now that I've done that.
About him seems so impossible.
So wait, Tim's made up. They just invented.
Why do you act so true? Forget Tim. No one actually wins. Yes, they want control. Yes, they want control, actually. Okay, look. Okay, so here's the thing.
That's awful.
They want to control, and so that's a great way to bring up Tim. But if I would have just said that Tim was fake and then there's no way to win, like it was telling me the other option, then that would have just been like, all right, that's it. That they just lost hope and would have lost it. But no, we have surprise on our side. Exactly.
Don't know that we know. We have surprise on our side.
Surprise.
Exactly.
That'll be a ton of help when a gladiator.
We know the truth, but no one else does.
Yeah, I mean, like, your plan to take down the old builders sounds cool and all, but those gladiators are, like, super tough.
And now, like, those gladiators is actually something I can talk about, too. Give yourself some credits. We'll outnumber them.
I mean, totally.
Okay. Actually, yeah, we do outnumber them. That is true. There's only three gladiators, and there's how many of us? I mean, there's five of us on my team alone. There's M, who used to be a gladiator. The hippie, that's seven now. And then plus the other teams, which, yeah, we've killed two yellow guys, and then, what was it? A couple other ones? Either way, though. Here we go. We are Tim.
Tim, because we are Tim.
Exactly.
Not real? I can't believe it.
Well, everyone seemed to be happy with my speech, so I think I did it.
Look, it was a nice speech.
But Silver Tongue perk for the win? Yay, Fallout?
Action speak.
I definitely want to say yay, Fallout. Silver Tongue perk for the win.
My strength comes from my friends. We're always there for each other.
Exactly. Unlike you, who's betrayed your team.
And I used to be a bad guy.
I like how Ivor keeps actually referencing that. He's like, I used to be bad. I used to kill people, but you know, I'm okay now. I only nearly took over the world and ate everyone, but meh, it's fine.
Reaction definitely seemed mixed.
Yeah, no.
It had to get through. There's no way around it. If it didn't, we're screwed.
Yeah,
exactly. It had to get through or else we're in big trouble. Exactly.
Well, I guess we'll find out for sure in the morning.
Well, we did it. We found out the truth. Tim is fake. Hadrian would try to, like, I guess, use our new deal to his advantage if we would have taken it. And we now know that we may have the people on our side, I think. I mean, after all, we did tell them the truth, and they all were applauding us and cheering, so there is that.
The final day of the game! Are our competitors ready for the final challenge? The wall!
Why'd she cut off
scared?
Otto? That's really weird.
No one will
judge you for it.
After putting up with not scared in the slightest.
Please, this walls thing doesn't scare me at all.
Still got your sense of humor, huh? Cute.
Hey man, Palma said I was cute, and if the computer says that I'm being cute, then clearly I have the greatest sense of humor. It's fine. Even if it is a very snarky sense of humor, I don't care. Alright, so what do we got? We got a tree, another guy has a tree. They have a craft table to start off with. Oh, cool. So does the purple team. Sweet.
Wait,
what? Yeah, I was gonna say, we don't have a tree.
Is that gonna be a problem?
Yeah, but I'm going to have to make it work. There's no way around it. I'm going to have to make it work.
Can't wait.
Once the walls are down, it's every team for themselves.
But is surviving the walls the end, Mevia?
No, it is not, Hadrian. Whichever team survives the free-for-all needs to step onto the winner's platform in the center of the arena.
Winner!
But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Because that's only if the would-be winners can defeat...
Gladiator! That's right! So all competitors better get to gathering materials, because that clock is ticking!
So the gladiators can win
themselves.
The citizens can... Oh, my. Okay, hold on a second. Can I talk to Face Meat here for a second?
They're happy you didn't get anything. I think they're making fun of you. But just my, you know... professional opinion. Who's heard this a lot?
Yeah. Yeah, we're kind of screwed, and that's fairly obvious.
Rhetorical question.
Okay, first off, crafting table. Is there something up with this crafting table?
I actually had anything to craft with.
Apparently not. Okay, is there anything under the dirt that I can click on? Anything at all? Okay, the gravel. Maybe I can make a flint. Maybe we'll find a piece of iron in here or something.
Gravel, that's worse than dirt.
Okay, to be fair, again, I can make flint, and if I find a piece of steel or something, I can at least make a flint and steel and cause fire.
Nope.
I will take that. That's just dirt. Okay, nothing good yet. Can I take a piece of the sand? I guess it's touched the wall, but at the same time, the wall does come down anyway, so maybe I can take some sand and just dig up.
I'm guessing that's the eponymous wall.
No, I can't take sand. Okay, so... I have gravel, and I have dirt, and, okay, coarse dirt. This is both gravel and dirt hybrid, which is nothing. Okay, we're screwed. We are done. Give up, go home. We've got nothing.
Oh, do you know what time it is? Ask me what time it is, Mevia.
What time is it, Hadrian?
It's time for the walls to come
down. Oh, crap. Well, this is gonna suck. Okay, well then. He's got a hoe that will never break. He's got a sword. He's got a fishing pole to pull us closer. And he's got a pick. A pick is actually kind of smart. Because at least he can, like, dig through things. Oh my gosh. The hippie's so happy. Yo, man! We're so here for you. Yeah! Oh, come on, dude. You with us or not? Don't do this, Sim. What do you got? Yeah, don't do this, honestly.
Already made up my mind.
Oh, so we're dead. We're dead. Okay. So if I would have been nicer to her is what I'm understanding here, it would have been fine, but I'm going to have to run now. Maybe. I mean, technically, in the real walls challenge, you can actually go into other people's areas. You just got to run. Wait, what? Hey, now. Hey, now.
Thought I'd try giving that friends thing a shot.
Hey, there we go. All I had was dirt and gravel.
Let me tell you, all I had was dirt and gravel.
Gross. Could still come in handy, though.
Gross.
What is Sam doing? Why is she doing that?
I have no idea.
Come on. Over here.
Yeah, see, this is what I was saying. Everyone can cross over to their own area, so I don't know why we didn't.
Yeah, man, I can totally...
Lay down your weapons. We're done fighting.
Yeah, we're...
You liked being used like pawns. Actually, yes. This is something that Slab said. He doesn't like being used. He doesn't like it.
Use you like this?
Exactly. He doesn't like being a pawn. This is great.
Like awesome people?
No, like little pieces in their games, doing whatever they say.
Exactly.
Don't you see? None of us are the enemy.
They're the enemies. They're behind everything.
Oh, my God.
And we know that Slab doesn't like it.
Many perspectives.
And it appears that the gladiators are being idiots right now. Idiots!
Lovely.
What they should be doing is eliminating...
Hey, Hadrian, shut your cake hole.
Hey! Imbeciles. Wow. All right, here we go. Slab, think about it, dude. I have been on your side this whole time. Step aside, you big lugs. You should join. Actually, yeah, you should join us. Okay. I've done everything I possibly can to make you like me. Think about this, Slab. Give me my book, at least.
Weird.
They're just turning.
Going with them, Slab?
Wow.
In my life, I've done some things I'm not proud of. But
oh?
I don't work for bosses who use people or manipulate them. That's inconsistent.
Hey. Yeah, there we go.
When I was mean to you, pushed you around, and made you go to the tower with me, you got that I was just doing my job and came anyway so we could be on time. That was real considerate. I will join you, Tiny Jesse.
There we go. All right, cool. So we got him. I did something right, somehow. I guess I did two things right, because Emily didn't kill us either. So I did two things right.
Not eliminated may step on the victory platform and win the game. It looks like they are going to do this together.
So wait, is Slab meant to come up with us too, then?
You, Slab. You'll pay for that. That won't happen. It can't.
Yeah. Yeah, so Slab's going to climb with us, actually. Oh, this is going to be interesting then. So we have everyone, except for the three other gladiators, but we have the gladiator leader, so it makes me want... Yeah, look, Slab is there. This is interesting, actually. I was not expecting something like that. This is interesting, actually. I can honestly, I'm very shocked by that. I was not expecting that at all.
You eliminate each other.
You've lost at your own game. Exactly.
Get me started with you, Emily.
I don't know, Hadrian.
We won. We followed the rules. And like I said, if there's a chance we're going to bend the rules in our favor, we did exactly what the game said. Anyone who's on the platform wins. You lost by your own definition.
This isn't up to you. We control the game. We decide their outcome.
And you just admitted it. Exactly. Just admit it. You lost. That's it. So you admit they're rigged. Exactly. Exactly.
Sure. Okay. Sure. Fine. Whatever.
Mevia.
There it is.
Won these games fair and square.
There it is. So Otto. Otto's done it. He's done it. He found a way to finally beat them down.
Carefully about what you're doing.
I have. Jesse. With the power vested in me as an officiator of the Builder Games, I am proud to take my oath.
What are you doing?
Lovely.
Now it's been
okay, Obsidian. All right.
But I think it's about time we end this.
Whoa. This is majorly...
Whoa. Oh, my gosh. All right, here we go.
Now.
However, Harper still has a diamond pick, so this isn't over yet.
Forever. I am 100% fine with that course of action.
This isn't over yet. We're still good to go.
Fine by me. The hard way is more fun anyway.
Oh, are they blocking off everyone?
This is useless.
Oh, I didn't realize.
Just when you thought...
Em, come back!
Now that you've lost...
Oh, crap.
Again, you really don't stand a chance.
But hold on, where is...
I'm still with you, Jesse.
Yeah, there we go. I was going to say, where is Slab?
You're going to need all the help you can get.
Let's do this, dude. I've got Slab on my side now, at least. Dodge. And attack. No, he's got a shield. Of course he does.
But not quick enough for my axe.
Oh, what the?
Don't forget my axe, Hadrian.
Oh, crap. Hi, hi. How are you? Are you good? I hope so. You nearly killed me on that one. I will admit to that. Wow, what a combo.
It was an honor to fight beside you.
What? Oh my gosh.
Gotta admit, kid.
Wow, that was dark very fast.
But
It was an honor to fight beside you as he blew himself up for us. Wow. That was unexpected, to say the least.
Is that enough, Hadrian?
Wait! You're right! This has gone too far!
What a coward. As soon as he's down, he's done. He's like, no! No, please, don't kill me! Whoa. What a coward.
Get away from you before?
Let me get you. Forgive me?
No. Now I'm just going to straight up say no. I talked about this earlier in the fifth episode. Wait, what?
And that's our game, sports fans.
The Redstone Heart has been returned to its proper owners.
What? So Slab just died. We just died.
I lost.
Hey, fancy meeting you here. You know?
Oh, what up, dude?
Competitors to these respawn pits. Never knew it hurt so much. Sorry. That's probably not helping your mood right now.
To be fair, no, but that was actually more considerate than I was expecting, to be fair.
It's us! Yeah!
Hey! There you go!
I know you said you were done helping me, but I hope you can give me another chance. You know.
For that, yeah.
And we both need to get out of this.
I actually wouldn't mind a little help.
Looks like an under.
I definitely agree with that one, actually.
Got you, buddy.
But I lost my inventory when I respawned. How am I supposed to get the Atlas back without any weapons or armor or anything?
Well,
do they have anything in their pockets, maybe?
In Hadrian's inventory room and helped ourselves to a few things.
Diamond picks, okay. I'm definitely okay with diamond picks. My weapon of choice. I don't really care about the sword, but okay. Diamond axe, okay.
Over here.
Oh. Oh. Wait, what? Really?
Time to kick some old builder butt.
That's amazing.
To go with my sweet new armor.
Wait, I have to pick the... That's it. Like I said, we did it last time. Diamond picks. And it's got to be the same. We will dig our way out of this situation. There's no way about it.
Sweet.
We did it with a diamond pick last time. We defeated the ultimate evil. And plus, we can save these people now with the pick.
Well, Mevia.
We're going to do it. Free everyone. Take them out as a team.
Doesn't seem like punishment enough. I have something special in mind for them.
Hadrian! Mevia! This game just went into overtime.
I look amazing. It's fine.
Well, isn't that cute? You found 10
it's time you were eliminating. I... You'll beg for another deal. That's actually kind of great. You underestimate your friends, though. I think that's kind of the point of this whole entire thing.
Those friends of yours will just hold you back in the end, slugger. Oh, I'm going to enjoy crushing you.
All right, let's go. I'm glad that a pick is just strong enough. That's great. But I have a double pick. I can dual wield this, technically. Oh, shield. Nice. Nice. Check that out. Sweet. There's the axe. Okay. Oh. The struggle. The struggle. The struggle. There it is. Knock her back. Really? That's all you're going to do is just dig up? Oh, hi. That's not what I was expecting. Get it up. Get it up. Get it up. Nice. Okay. Oh, that's a hole. That is a big old hole. Look, I picked the diamond picks as my actual weapon of choice. I was going to free everyone else, but I can free myself as well. There we go. I'm free. You've got nothing on me, dude. I have a diamond pick now.
No, it can't be.
Exactly, chick. You're done. Oh. Wow. Okay, I wasn't expecting something like that. I watched her just get crushed. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. Also, can we get on that platform, just straight battle him out on that, and then just take out a block underneath him? Is that possible? I would do that. I mean, it would technically kill him, too. It would put him into the respawn pit. We're on here. Like I said, just pull out the diamond pick. Pull out the diamond pick right here and just knock out one block. All you have to do.
You mess with one member of the Order of the Stone,
You mess with all
go,
of us.
Go, Jesse! I believe
time
in you!
Time to shut you up!
I just love that Slab's in there, actually. That makes me happy.
You're deluded!
Let's take him to the Slab Lab.
The Slab Lab? What?
I'm still workshopping that one. Shut up. Let's go.
The Slab Lab. That's great. The Slab Lab. I like it.
Shut up. Just shut up. Alia, shut up.
Dude, while he's talking, just pop out the block. Remember Spleef. Exactly. Like I said, pop out the block. Dodge. And then there it is. And there he goes. How the mighty have fallen. And honestly, like Jesse said, it was his pride that got to him. He got too prideful, and then when he was being cocky and he wasn't paying attention, we knocked that out. That was perfect. Holy crap, that was a lot. How big was his inventory? Jeez.
You and your stupid deals!
There's no time for that now, Mevia. We have to get out of here. Come on!
Also, how is he not naked? Ivor came out naked.
Whoa! Hey!
What?
Guys. How's it going?
I'm kind of shocked, actually.
It's going not the best.
Not the best. All right, there you go.
Yeah. Face Meat wants to discuss his benefits plan.
Oh, hang on!
What?
Jesse, you did it! Again!
Sweet.
Feels like I say that a lot. I couldn't have done anything without all of you. Well done, Jesse.
And Slab, even though he's not in there for whatever reason.
Thanks, Otto.
I'm actually really happy that we got Slab. Like, I feel like that was a completely optional thing to do. And I'm actually really happy that I got that. That's really cool.
Start over.
Man, do you need some new friends, you know that?
Yes, I've come to that same conclusion, and I am working on it.
That's probably for the best, to be fair.
That the Atlas is not mine to keep.
Sweet. Oh, they're beating the crap out of them. That's fair. That's fair.
You get to decide their fate. And with the Atlas, you can send them anywhere you want.
Ooh. A world of ultimate torture, in other words.
Olivia and I used to play back in our treehouse.
Huh?
What?
Remember? We called it, which would you rather fight?
Oh, the 10 zombie-sized chickens or the 100 chicken-sized zombies. That's what it was. Oh, that's so cool. That's a reference all the way back to the first episode. Wow.
That's when I yanked Thomas Redstone Heart.
That's amazing.
The whole thing shut down.
Or no, it's a zombie. 100 zombie-sized chickens. That's what it was. I had to think about that. So basically, 100 baby zombies or 10 zombie chickens. That's what it was. I remember making that joke.
All
right, cool. So everyone's free then.
Except you folks, that is. I can't believe how many competitors actually want to stay and keep playing the games.
That's rather shocking, actually.
New friend, I can actually work on making them fun again.
Okay, well then, if he knows what he wants to do, always happy to help. Promise he'll stay fun.
But a good challenge.
Who would want to stay?
Want to stay? Seems kind of weird.
They are pretty fun games, you know.
They are? Okay, I won't argue it then.
Well, out of hand before, but I'm going to make sure that doesn't happen again.
Okay, if you're the leader, I will believe that.
You taught me a lot about fairness, Jesse. And I'd like to use that new knowledge for something good. Oh,
dude, that's amazing.
Speaking of fairness, I think this is yours.
Yes, I did it! Ah, yes!
Good stuff in there.
Ah, that's amazing. Yes, I did it. Just for that alone.
So immovable.
Boom.
After all.
Really? Really? One-liners? That's okay.
Well,
Punky, get out of here. You're never talking to us ever again. Get out.
Yes,
you're done. We hate you now.
If it's what I want.
Really?
You get to leave and go on more adventures. Do I really want to go back to farming? I mean, it has
well,
been
I mean,
I've seen it.
Your home is waiting. Help Otto fix the games. Come with us.
What if I'm bored?
Sounds like
well, then
Otto's
help Otto fix the games.
Like
yeah.
The games. You could stick around and help with that.
Jesse, that's an awesome.
I mean, obviously, we've got Slab being like the fair gladiator.
Yeah.
Why doesn't Emily then become like a sensei, so to speak. And then, like, she becomes the guy that teaches everyone what to do. Like, hey, if you want a strategy, do this. Hey, if you want to know about this game, come do this, etc.
Just observing Harper, all by herself, over there.
He still wants her, man. Say goodbye, let her be. Say goodbye. Obviously, you like her, dude. We all know that you like her. Just go say goodbye to her. Or maybe go and hook up with her finally. Obviously, you've been flirting with her for two whole episodes now.
Well, I guess this is goodbye. I'm going to head on back to Crown Mesa and see how the post-Palma construction is going. Just hope.
Exactly. We did make that deal.
A real home, but
I'm glad she's honoring it.
I've had for, well, a long time. We'll just go with
that. Yeah, they'll come around.
If
you work fair and you don't do anything to jeopardize the relationship you already have done, you'll be fine.
I was a bad guy, Hump. Can be awkward, but hopefully soon they'll invite you right back into their lives. Right, Jesse?
Like I said, he really likes to reference the whole entire I was a bad guy thing. He really does.
But you know something? You're okay.
Hey.
Take care of each other, all right?
Insert blush. Definitely. Definitely blushing.
Yes, goodbye.
Come on.
Oh my gosh, what the heck, man. All right, well then, there you go.
Amazing.
Whoa, he kept the flower. He kept her flower. What a weirdo.
Well, Atlas belongs to Jesse now. Deal's a deal and all that.
Cool.
Sweet.
Take the Atlas then. Let's do it.
Work. Now you just say where you want to go, and the Atlas will show you the way. Why don't you just go ahead and open it?
Okay, say I want to go home.
Take us home.
Okay, that works too. Take us home, whatever, either way.
Whoa. Spectacular.
Oh, that's kind of like the enchantment. Like how you can actually see like the enchanted words come out. Where's it going? It's going. It's going. Ah, a wood door. All right. I wonder how close they were to this. Like, if you actually go back and look at every portal scene, I wonder how close they were to this portal.
Here we come.
Huh. All right, let's go. Well, there we go. We made it home. Perfect. That's it, then. We did it, guys. That's the end. Wow. Wait, that's not it? Oh, well, this is probably the credits. I didn't think about that. Wow. That's crazy.
Jesse,
but we're home.
Look. Can you believe it? We made it. We're home.
After all that time, all those portals... We're home.
Yeah, and I couldn't have done it without you guys. You're the best team anyone could ever ask for.
Aw.
That's lovely.
Aw, you big sap.
I'm just so glad
really?
We're all back together.
That Atlas is so cool. I'm glad Otto let you keep it.
Fabulous, yes! And that's not all we got. Seriously? What else?
Of course. Ivor's like, we got all kinds of treasure. I like all the treasure. My favorite was the Eversource. That's why we wanted it in the first place. Wait, do I have to pick one? Oh, I do have to pick one. Okay, well then, let's just go in order. It started with the flint and steel. We wouldn't be here without it.
The one that started the whole thing.
Yeah, none of these other adventures could have happened if it weren't for this.
Exactly. So then, obviously, next would be the Eversource crown.
The magical source of all of Sky City's precious materials.
Whoa, wicked!
But there you go, that answers that question. It's the answer to everyone. We didn't realize. I thought it was the chicken that had the power, but no, that answered that. It was the crown that had the power, not the chicken. That's interesting. But there we go. Okay, so next up, the White Pumpkin.
The mask of Cassie Rose, a.k.a. the White Pumpkin.
Oh, man.
The murder that I called halfway through the story. Yes. All right. Palma's heart.
Palma's redstone heart.
I know that Palma was evil and everything, but I still kind of wish I could have seen it.
Of course you would, to be fair. You're obsessed with everything. And then finally,
Atlas.
The portal.
I could have lost all the rest so long as we got to keep that. Huh? I wonder what Sorin would have thought of it.
Again,
so
Sorin.
Power contained within
Why are we bringing up Sorin so much?
Easy there, Ivor.
sorry.
And also, so much power locked up in a tiny object. That's kind of referencing the F-bomb. When he made the Formidabomb, he even made that comment. He was like, this is a very small object, but it's big enough to blow up the Witherstorm. That's very interesting. Wait a minute. Hold on. Is that another glitch, or are those things missing?
I've been writing stuff in here, you know? And, well, it's kind of become like a legitimate book. There's just one
problem.
I still need to put what happened to you.
Greatest hero ever. We returned home safely. Impossible without my friends. Evil was vanquished.
Happened to the hero.
Yeah, we all returned home safe.
Just put down that I got home safe and reunited with all my friends.
Exactly.
Nice and simple. I like it.
Exactly.
Then, done. Well, tell the next one anyway. I was thinking
maybe
we could put it in here with the other treasures. I know it's not as cool as like a portal atlas or a redstone heart.
That's a great idea. I want to actually read this book.
Hang on.
Okay.
What is it?
Wasn't that where the portal atlas was a minute ago?
That's what I said. Was it a glitch? Because we already know that these episodes have been glitching, but...
Flint and Steel are missing too.
And where's Ivor?
And hold on a second. It said until the next one.
He must be headed for the portal network.
And he says, adventure.
What should we do? I mean, I guess he mostly knows what
we have to catch up.
We have to catch up with him.
Is that it? So, okay, hold on a second. So, Lucas says, until the next one, meaning that they may have something planned. Ivor says, adventure. Come on, guys, let's go catch him. What? Oh, this is interesting. Oh, this is very interesting. Okay, let's look at our results here, because I was like looking at these to see if we fall in the majority or the minority here. But here we go. All right. You and 76% of players rescue Petra. No one likes Lucas, dude. I only saved Petra because, like I said, I didn't know what to do. I panicked, and we saved her last time, so I was like, all right, carry on through. That's why I did it. That was my reasoning. I guess because I didn't pick Lucas, it kind of put me into that. Kind of. I don't really know how I feel about that one. So, majority for that. Minority, you and 32% of players chose to not trust. Why would you trust her? You saw she ran through there. No one stopped her. Why would you trust that? Okay. Whatever. I'm not going to say anything. Okay. You do what you do. I did what I did. You do what you do. All right. Anyway, you and 87% of people rescued Nell. Okay, now that I can understand. We would have had her die. And like I said, we scratched her back and she scratched our back. It was the least I could do would be to save her. And I mean, I don't know. I definitely feel that she deserved to live. I don't think that she did anything wrong to die in the first place. If anything, M should have died. All right, there we go. So that's my reasoning. I definitely agree with that one that we're in a majority. Thumbs up for that one. You and 58% rejected Hadrian's New Deal. That's pretty close to about a 50-50 split. I mean, sure, it's closer to 60, and that'd be a 60-40, but still, that's still pretty close to about half and half, if you think about it. I mean, I understand what people are saying when, like, they're trying to sacrifice themselves to rescue their friends, and I fully respect that deal. But at the same time, I don't know. I mean, we heard it from the girl, from Harper, that she said that Hadrian would try to turn on you and be like, that was the new deal, blah, blah, blah. No, it's actually the original deal now. So, I don't know. That one seems kind of one-sided. But I guess I am in the majority, technically. But I don't know. It's still pretty split 50-50. And then here we go. You and 31% of players helped M and Otto restart the games. Either people told her to join us, or they told her to go and be a farmer. I told her to help restart the games because I feel that she kind of had a change of heart, and that's why I feel like she deserved to have a chance to restart the games, and that's why I said that. But that's my reasoning. So I think that's it, though. A journey's end? Question mark? Yeah, that's totally it. So, guys, oh my gosh, that was it. Wow. Okay, so hold on a second. I want to go over this for a minute here. Lucas, again, said that that's it for now. Until the next one. Then we had the clue of if you didn't even save the journal with Slab, which I'm really glad I did, first off. But if you didn't save the journal, you then have going off toward the portal realm, Ivor, screaming, "Adventure!" Which he's done the last three episodes now, and then he finished it with the fourth one. So I guess it kind of makes you think, like, oh, hey, another adventure is coming. And then you could have chose, like, oh, no, he'll be back, we'll go get him, or just wait here, or say nothing. We chose go after him, obviously. But that's very interesting. I feel like there's going to be another set of stories to this. This could be very interesting. I can't wait to see what they do with this. This is really good. So, guys, to wrap up this whole project, I loved this project. This project was so much fun for me to do. I don't even know what to say. Like, this project made me cry at times. You guys heard it when we lost those people. I didn't know what to say because I got attached to these characters. I mean, we're having each episode be about an hour and a half to 2 hours, depending on which episode you guys watched. I cried when we lost her, when we lost our Redstone engineer. You guys know who she is, and if you guys didn't watch the episodes, go back and watch that. And I'm not going to say her name just for that reason. It's definitely not because I forgot her name, because I didn't, I swear. Anyway, with that being said, then we lost our best friend. We lost Ruben. You guys even saw it get referenced in every episode. And then the fact that the guy's like, I tried to tell you my name was Ruben, but I'm not the best friend. I mean, I understand that it's supposed to be a comedy section, but it's still trying to show you, you feel for Ruben. This character that you've become, like you've become Jesse, he lost his best. He watched him die. Technically, you kind of sacrificed him. I mean, he didn't technically be like, I'm going to kill you and cut a sword into him. But at the same time, he held him in his arms as he died. You can't, like, understand the fact of how grievance that is whenever you watch a pet or a friend or just someone die in your arms. I mean, that's just like, hey, I'm going to go take my dog to the taxidermy and just let it shoot it up with a needle and let it die in your arms. It's the same concept. There's something inside of you that just is crushed when you do that. And the fact that it's referenced through every episode in the second set shows you the attachment that this character had to it. And then the fact that we became like this cocky band of heroes 3 months after what we saved the world. Sure, we saved the world and that's great. But it actually shows like, ha, we're all that now. We become cocky. These characters actually have emotions. They have feelings. And how much you're able to change the story based on how you play is amazing. Like this whole entire Slab thing. I feel like that was something that you didn't have to do. If you talked to the miner, maybe you did something with the miners. Maybe they gave you a present. Maybe they gave you a, hey, if you come to the mines with us, we'll do this for you. And there's an alternate way to win the game. I don't know. But I chose to help out Slab, and he helped us in the end. And he's going to go and make the games fair. I don't even know what to say. But just, it's crazy to think of how much this game has not even affected me even, but you guys too. I've heard you guys make comments to me on the old timer, even in the actual video itself, just be like, this game made me do this. This game made me go out and buy it. I know a couple of you guys that have bought it. Like Yasmin, she bought it. Top, she bought it. You guys have bought this game because of my Let's Play, and it's crazy. This game has done so much for the channel, but for even us as a community, just to be able to talk about this, even on stream. And I'd like to thank all of you guys who have done that. So, with all of my ramblings out of the way, everyone, thank you guys so much for coming out for this amazingly short but deep Let's Play, guys. I had fun, and I hope you guys did too. So, guys, thank you all so much for coming out, everyone. And thank you all for those of you who stuck through me through all 8 of these episodes, even though they're extremely long. Wait, what? That's not over? Okay, I was going to end it right here, but apparently not. So we got 100 chickens. So 100 chicken-sized zombies is what they picked.
In the land of chickens that are indeed the size of zombies.
I was right. That's amazing.
That's right, Adrian. And it looks like we're just going to have to wing it.
And I hate her for her puns. Yeah, I really hate her for her puns. And I'm really glad that like they're still trying to like be like and in the next one, like they're trying to actually do like their job even though they're stuck in this chicken dimension, so to speak. It's kind of funny actually that they're keeping up their character, their persona of a sports announcer, so to speak. But yeah, okay, I want to check this out here for a second here. Episodes. I know this is kind of a little weird that I'm doing this, but I actually want to check this out. Because I feel like there's going to be something else. Like, maybe they added something. Thank you for purchasing all episodes of Minecraft Story Mode Season 1. Hold on. Season 1. That answered it. So Ivor running away and Lucas saying the whole entire until next time one. That's it. There's going to be another season. Maybe not in a year, maybe not in 2 years, but it sounds like there's going to be another season. That's great. Oh, I cannot wait for that. So guys, thank you all so much for coming out, everyone. I had a blast, and I hope you guys did too. Thank you guys for sticking around for this long. And until next time, everyone, and until the next project even, this is OGM, and I'm signing out.